a game as a kid when you were out for recess and there was like a riddle where you took like a dandelion and they'd be like da 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 and then he peed down your arm and then you dragged it and then it made like a yellow streak? If you guys remember that, tell me, because I just had a weird flashback of it. Hi friends, my name is Shaz and this is Shazness Wellness. Today is a really special day because I'm actually at the Pickering Library and I was asked to come here to do like a how to in 10. So obviously my topic is how to have a happy gut in 10 minutes. So in order to make my booth more exciting, I brought some juices and pants to do a giveaway. So I'll show you the table quick before people come. It's already like 11 and they're supposed to be here at 11. So here's my little table. Shazness Wellness, how to have happy gut. I have some A+ smoothies here for digestive happiness for the veggie lovers. I have a giveaway for enjoy leggings. They're really soft, I love them. And then I have some business cards. And I have here if people want to sign up for one-on-one coaching or to be a wellness coach. Like a boss. I'm super excited that I was asked to be here by Shazness Wellness, and I'll keep you posted. I'm working on a side project right now where I'm trying to like build my own team of wellness coordinators and coaches and also start taking clients on for one-on-one coaching. So if you are interested in that, maybe just comment below and let me know if that's something you'd be interested in. In order to be a wellness coach, it's really great because you just earn some extra side cash. I would train you 100% to be a wellness coach and no experience required, because I just believe we are one. So if you have like a desire to want to help people and you don't know where to start, let me know. So I'm starving and people are gonna be coming soon, so I need to eat something. So I obviously have a salad here with chicken and avocado, and then my favorite mustard here. I'm gonna shove this in my mouth. Hopefully my makeup doesn't get too ruined and I don't ruin my lipstick, and hopefully no one comes while I'm shoving my face. And yeah, I'm excited, I'm nervous, and Hey friends, so I have no idea where I left off filming yesterday, but just to again fill you in, I was asked by one of my friends to come to the Pickering Library to kind of like have my booth set up to tell people like what I'm all about and to help people have a happy gut, because hashtag Shazness Wellness, hashtag team gut health. I decided to record outside because it's such a beautiful day, and if you hear birds or if it's loud, I am so sorry, but I mean, I gotta get me some vitamin D. In Canada, the nice weather doesn't last long, so I try to be outside as much as possible. So my original plan was to record a lot more yesterday at the library and just like the event, the how-to event. But then I realized like I should probably be asking people's permission if I'm recording them. Yeah. Anyways, the event was cool. Definitely awesome. But I'm not gonna lie, not my crowd of people. There were a lot more elderly people and kids. And every time I was like, hey, do you have social media? They're like, no. I'm like, okay, you want some juice? Pretty much, I feel like yesterday my day was educating people on how to have a happy gut and giving out free smoothies. And I'm so grateful for A+ smoothies and them giving me samples, because that was honestly a highlight. People just wanted free food, duh. There was legit a kid that like almost puked from trying it. She was like, I ate greens. And I tried my best to do an enjoy legging giveaway. So in order to participate in the giveaway, you had to use social media. Like all I asked was to do hashtag do you boo on one of my posts on either Instagram and Facebook. And like I said, every time I asked someone if they had Instagram or Facebook, it was like crickets. So it was 6 hours of talking to people and helping people, which I absolutely love, but not one person participated in my legging giveaway, which was kind of sad. And just to top it off, I was handing a little girl a green juice, and as I was passing it to her, it was like in slow motion. I could feel like, no, and she's like, ugh, and then dropped all of the green juice on the enjoy leggings that I was supposed to give away. So it kind of worked out that no one wanted to do the giveaway, because I wouldn't have had any pants to give away because they were full of green juice. But anyways, let's talk about what I discuss with people if they came up to me and said, how to have a happy gut. These were my go-to answers. Number one, stress management. There is an immediate brain-gut connection. As you know, when you see someone you like, you get nervous in your tummy, or when you have a big date coming up, you feel your appetite kind of changes. So that's an immediate brain-stomach reaction. And if you are consistently stressed out, you have cortisol increasing, and it's just going to affect your digestion. I don't know if you've ever tried eating angry. Usually you don't want to eat because you're just like so angry, or you throw your food, or you probably end up with a stomach ache because who wants to eat angry? Like, eating should be like the best part of your day, is it not? Like, for me it is, at least. I know some people out there that eat just to survive, and I'm like, who are you? So going back to my point of stress management, the biggest tip I have is just eating mindfully. As you're eating, chew your food, smell it, feel it on your tongue, you know, feel it go down your esophagus and into your tummy, and thank the food for providing your body with the energy it needs, and to put that smile on your face, because food is highlights of most people's lives. I mean, if you can relate to this, you would understand. And I don't know if you've swallowed big chunks before, but that can't be good for you, your stomach, and your bowels. So chew your damn food. My second biggest tip for having a happy gut is reducing your sugar. I brought this up to everyone at the library yesterday. They weren't happy to hear this, but honestly, sugar is super inflammatory to your system and just really irritates the gut lining. And in addition to that, sugar is super addicting. It's more addicting than cocaine. Not saying you can't have sugar ever, but there's definitely ways of finding substitutes of your cravings. So a big one I always suggest, that if you crave pancakes or bread in the morning, try making 3-ingredient pancakes, which is just a ripe banana, 2 eggs, and some cinnamon. You mash up the banana, you put 2 eggs, you scramble all that together, you put a dash of cinnamon, and then you fry it in coconut oil. Tastes great. Personally, when I eliminated sugar in my diet, that's when my gut was able to heal a lot more, because it just forced me to eat more whole foods, more vegetables. It stopped me from craving the extra chocolate and the extra candy and the breads and stuff like that. And it just gave my digestion more time to heal. My third tip to how to have a happy gut is probiotics. Not necessarily having to buy them, because it can get confusing. There's many different strains and brands, and it becomes overwhelming and pricey, but just fermented vegetables. Maybe for a weekend you can make homemade pickles together. Probiotics. Just shove some cucumbers in a jar with water and salt, and then let it sit, because it's not too hard to do. Then you got your probiotics. Obviously, you can get it from kombucha and kefir and yogurt. I just believe in a dairy-free diet, so I just think fermented vegetables are the easiest and cheapest way to get probiotics in your diet. My fourth tip is collagen bone broth. Bringing it back to them ancient times, having collagen in your diet is super soothing for the digestive system, and to me personally, really helps me have a happy gut. When I was going through really bad gut problems, I honestly drank bone broth every single morning on an empty stomach. After waking up, your stomach is fasted, and the first thing I wanted to touch my intestinal linings is, oh sweet collagen, just brushing the lining, making sure it's all smooth and beautiful. You can make bone broth by using a slow cooker and boiling good organic animal bones and onions and garlic and whatever you want to put in there for about 24 hours, or you can buy bone broth powders and proteins. Both are great, but either way, collagen in your diet is super important. Not getting into the nitty-gritties of gut health, those are my best 4 tips to give yesterday, and it really created some good conversation, and it helped me understand what other people's perspective was of gut health. I think most people have heard of probiotics at this point, but really never considered making something like sauerkraut or homemade pickles. The amount of fun eyes I got from telling people how to make 3-ingredient pancakes always just fills my heart, because it's something so simple, and a lot of kiddies would love it as well if you're a mom or a dad and you cook, you know, if you're a parent. So I think I'm gonna close this video here. It's gonna be a really crazy week for me. I am moving at the end of this week, June 1st, into our new place. I'm gonna be packing and stressed out and trying my best to stay namaste, but moving is just so annoying and so stressful, but I will find the positives. I will find the gratitude within the journey. I hope you like this video. If you have any tips on how to have a happy tummy, comment them below because we are all one. We can all help each other. I just want to build a community where we can just spread the love and spread some gut health love. If you liked this video, please give me a thumbs up because it just really supports my channel and lets me know what type of videos you like. And subscribe because I make videos every week, especially on Wednesdays. Sending good vibes and good times. XOXO, Shazness, Wellness. Bye, friends!